Saturday morning.
Saturday morning. We didn't do nothing yesterday other than deadhead down from Oklahoma to Texas.
Yes, sir. We found an RV park not far from our pickup. It's actually in Belton, Texas. It's called Basin RV Park. Oh, man, it's a really nice little RV park.
Not bad. No. Not bad. I would have wished that they had like a grills at the campsites, but they do have like a community grill.
Yeah.
So, I mean... Oh well.
I'm just glad they let us stay here.
So, yeah.
We called and sent them a picture of the of our truck, so to make sure they would let us stay here, and they said yeah. They said y'all have an awesome truck.
Yeah. We are so here for the whole weekend.
Yes.
Until Tuesday morning. We check out Tuesday morning because our load don't pick up till next week on Tuesday. So we are just gonna chill out. You know what sucks is. It's probably going to rain today.
I think it's 80% chance, and then 50 tomorrow.
Yeah. It's like, we can't win. We get a weekend off, and it's rainy. It was raining in Illinois when we stayed at that KOA, too. So it's
We do have a few things we want to do. Some on the inside, so we'll be able to do that. I want to get the shower done and a couple other things. But Monday it's supposed to be nice. It's supposed to be sunny. So maybe we can do the outside stuff.
Yeah, we'll probably do the outside stuff. So there's a lot of full-timers here at this RV park that we don't want to do it on the weekend. And just, you know, they'll be looking at us like, what are you doing? what is this, a truck stop now?
Yeah, and, we don't want
to
do
that. We want to try to be mindful of, you know, thank you for allowing us to stay here kind of thing and not be... doing all kinds of truck things on the outside. So Monday, I'm sure a lot of them will be left and gone to work. So we'll probably
if their work is open.
If their work is open, I know. Gosh, we're still in this crazy.
I know.
I keep waiting for like to wake up and just it all be a crazy dream.
It's crazy. But we'll leave a link to this RV park in the description if any of y'all are out in this area and looking for a place to stay. They do allow our trucks, so that's really awesome. We like to share when we find places because I know some people have hard times finding places that'll let them stay.
Yeah.
So we'll share that. We'll always, like I said, link it in the description box. So
yeah, it'll be like a Google Maps link so you can.
Or if they have a website, I'll link that.
Yeah.
Which most places do.
Yeah. Just try to make sure your truck is nice and clean before you come. You know, we don't want to burn places like this that do allow us, you know.
Yeah, but we're going to take advantage of, they got some really nice facilities here that are open, the shower rooms, which we're going to go shower here after this and we'll take in and get a few clips of that because they've got a really unique shower. Most campgrounds or most RV parks, like they don't have little separate showers. It's a bathroom and then they have separate showers in the bathroom.
Yeah,
These actually have separate shower rooms, which is really cool. We saw it yesterday. They do have laundry here, which I'm going to take advantage of that and get our laundry done.
Yeah. They got like a little cool community room that, you know, they allow. It's open 24/7. They give you like a door code that to get into. And
we'll show you
washroom, showers, all that. That's all open 24 with a gate or keypad code.
Yeah.
So.
Really nice. I don't think it's that old. Maybe a year old.
Yeah.
It's not very old. It's pretty new. It's
funny. These are the times that we really enjoy trucking. You know, being able to get away from the truck stops and the craziness. RV people are usually pretty to themselves. You know, they don't they're not bugging or, mm-hmm. you know, they're not bothering you and stuff. And
although we do get a lot of people when we stay in RV parks just curious about the truck. Like, yeah. what do we use it for? What is it? You know, we get a lot of questions. Last night we were sitting out and we had a couple people stop and talk to us. And just curious about the truck, like, which is kind of cool.
What's in the back? Somebody thought it was a game room back there. A man cave.
I like that we get to, you know, share the lifestyle with people. And actually, when we got here yesterday, we were setting up. We had somebody come up to us and say they knew us. They watched our videos.
So. They seen us pulling into the park and they knew who we were.
Yeah. Shout out Jenny if you're watching. Thank you for coming and say hi. Hi. Yeah, she watches our videos.
Nice meeting her.
Yeah, it's so cool when we go to places and
it's such a random place.
Unexpected, right?
Yeah. You wouldn't expect anybody here to know the Crafty Truckers, you know?
but it was so nice meeting her.
They're from Oklahoma, and they're down here trying to find, they're in the oil field business, you know, and they're down here trying to look for work and stuff. So,
good luck
to you guys. We really hope you find something.
Yeah.
And,
absolutely. But we're just, like I said, we're going to get around, shower, do some things today, but we'll show you around the park and let you know what we do while we're here for the weekend, I guess.
Cool.
All right.
Evening.
It's the end of Sunday fun day.
Yeah, we had fun today.
We did have fun today. What did we do?
We hung out, chatted with some like-minded expediters today. It was funny. We were coming down here near Belton, Texas, and we planned on getting an RV park for the weekend since our next load don't pick up till Tuesday. And Heather was looking through our emails, and it just so happened there was another team that we helped get into expediting. That was pretty
cool. Rose and Michael.
Yeah, that they were in this area looking for an RV park to stay at. And usually we would stay at the state parks and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just because we like those better. They're cheaper usually. But they're all closed right now. So we told them, hey, we're here at this park if you want to come hang out or... And sure enough, they came and got a spot right next to us and stuff. So that was really cool.
Yeah, so we were visiting with them yesterday and today. We grilled out. It was really nice. They're with Panther.
Yeah, they're with Panther. They're actually picking up from the same exact place we're picking up from, but they pick up tomorrow. We pick up Tuesday, so we get one more day here.
Yeah.
But it was funny. They took advantage of the laundry and showers and stuff here, and so did we. Got the truck all nice and clean. Heather detailed it out.
We didn't get the other stuff done we wanted to do. Like,
we got one thing.
Yeah, we did get one thing done.
We got one thing done.
So I don't think we've told you, but when we were putting, you know, our landing gear is hydraulic, and I'd noticed the last couple of times I'd put it down and up, there was some hydraulic fluid leaking from one of the lines.
Yeah.
And it was only doing it when they were in motion.
Yeah.
So I figured it just needed tightened. So yeah, you got under there today and got that tightened
yeah.
up.
Yeah, I had that fixed in like 3 minutes. Mm-hmm. That was an easy fix. I just needed to tighten one of the hydraulic fluid lines that operates the landing gear and the lift gate. So
yeah, we'll probably pick up some hydraulic fluid just to top it off. Just, I don't think a lot came out, but just to have it on hand.
Yeah, it was just dirty under there from the hydraulic fluid that yeah. had leaked out. So yeah, we'll pick up, get it topped off at least. So.
Yeah, we do have, like Jason said, one more day here, so maybe we'll get a few of the little other things we need to get done. I don't know. We'll see.
We'll see.
We might just chill tomorrow. I don't know. You'll find out in the next vlog.
Yeah.
But this RV park was really nice. I'm glad we found it.
Really nice RV yeah. park. Oh my gosh. Like, I love the community here. The people here.
Everybody's so nice.
Everyone's so nice. Yeah. Like, people were out walking, getting exercise and stuff, and everybody would wave and, you know, say Happy Easter. Of course, Happy Easter to
yes,
everybody.
Happy late Easter if you yeah. celebrate. Of course, yeah. you'll be seeing this after Easter, but yeah. today is actually Easter.
For us, yeah.
Yes.
But
yeah.
People walk by. We even had a couple people say, thank you for doing what you do. And,
yeah,
you know,
as
just
truck drivers, yeah. like thanking us for being truck drivers,
yeah.
which was really
yeah.
awesome.
Yeah, yeah, we really, really nice community here of
yes.
people that they got. And a lot of full-timers, I think. You
yeah.
know, there's a lot of full-timers here, but,
yeah.
you know, they had kids riding around in the park on their bicycles and almost everybody has dogs.
Yeah.
One dog almost attacked
oh,
us today.
Yeah, you've probably seen clips, but they have a dog park here, and we took Tyson and Abby up there this afternoon because we got a little ball tosser for Abby.
Yeah.
And we wanted to play. She loves playing
she
ball.
She loves fetch.
And so we took him up there, and on the way up there, yeah, a guy was getting out of his RV. He had two dogs. One of them was a Spuds McKenzie looking dog.
Yeah.
I know there's a name for him. I don't know what they're called.
Yeah.
But it kind of started barking and running, lunging towards us. But he had it on a leash.
Almost pulled his arm off.
Yeah. And then they had a lab that came and kind of bum rushed up to us, which I don't think the lab would have done anything. It seemed like a very nice dog, but you just don't know when
the
a
way
big
he was
dog
running
starts
up.
Coming up to our
yeah.
little dogs. We just
he
it was
had his
scary.
He had his eyes set on our dogs,
yeah.
and I was like, no. Now I didn't kick him, but I put my leg up and like shoved
yeah.
him away, you know, once, and he kept coming back,
yeah.
and I had to do it a second time, and
yeah. Roy's leery, you know. I mean, I know there's a lot of big dogs that they just want to play and are curious, but you just don't know, you know. You see a big old dog coming towards your little dogs, it's scary.
Right. Yeah,
I mean, we get worried even letting them out, like at rest areas and things like that.
We
you
do,
know, for
yeah.
coyotes
yeah,
or
yeah.
critters.
We're always on the watch and
oh,
making
yeah.
sure our dogs are safe.
Yes,
but
that was a little scary, but nothing happened. Yeah. Everything's safe.
Like, my hands were full. I had GoPro and drink and ball and
yeah.
all
yeah, and they were on leashes and we were trying to hold them.
But then
good.
The owner of the dog came yeah. over to the dog park and was like, wanted to pet our dogs,
yeah.
or like, no, you can't touch our dogs. Our dogs are on social distancing right,
right.
now.
Right.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's a really nice RV park.
Yeah,
we would
really,
definitely
really nice.
Stay here
yeah.
again.
Yep.
And, oh no, probably a lot of you might be thinking, well, why didn't you stop by and see Mama Crafty? Because we did pass through Waco on the way down here, but the thing is with Mama Crafty is, you know, she's got health issues and we don't want to jeopardize her.
Yeah.
So, and we have to actually, we need to come home the end of April, beginning of May, because Jason's med cert expires in the end of May.
Yeah.
So we've got some other things we need to take care of, like registration for the Ford and things. So
yeah.
we
yeah.
already are planning to come home like in May. So we're like, you know, we'll not go home right now.
It wasn't
risk
worth
anything.
Yeah, it
you
wasn't
know.
Worth putting her in, because
no.
we've been all over the country and we could be asymptomatic and just carrying
right.
it.
Right, even
and
though
you
we don't
know.
Feel sick or anything. Right. You just don't
right.
know.
Right.
And we
right.
don't
right.
want to put her at risk.
Yep.
And
yep.
So, yeah, I mean, we would have loved to see Mama Crafty, but we'll be seeing her probably within the next month anyway. So, yeah, it kind of sad. We suck we didn't get to see her, but
yeah.
we'll
we're,
see her
next
soon.
Time we go home, we're buying her a big screen TV.
Yeah, yeah.
Her TV went out.
She had a big 65-inch TV, but it's one of, like, the old ones, you know?
That
that's
had
the real,
bulb.
Yeah,
and,
had
yeah.
the bulb and stuff.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
it like, she's had it for years, and the bulb would go out, and she would just have the bulb replaced, and it's getting harder and harder for her to get that replacement part and
no.
to get it fixed. So it happened again, and we told her, we're like, look, just
don't buy the bulb.
Don't
Let's,
buy, yeah.
We'll go get you a new TV.
We're going to buy her a new TV.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. One of a, like an LCD or
yes.
LED one,
yeah.
something that's
we
more
might have
up-to-date.
To order it and have it shipped because I don't, usually we buy stuff like that at Best Buy.
Yeah, yeah.
But I don't even think Best Buys are open right now. So, yeah. Well, you even read that there's a lot of, there's some cities or states that are banning like Walmart's, Targets and stuff from even
selling non-essential items like TVs and clothes. And
yeah, they can't sell any of that. So
that's just
yeah.
in some areas.
Yeah, it's not everywhere.
Rambling on.
I know. We're just rambling. We're tired.
We had a good weekend.
We did.
Had a good
we
weekend.
Had a really nice
got
weekend.
Got all the truck clean. That's, I mean, you got to keep up with this all the time.
And laundry. I got all the laundry
all the
done,
laundry,
which I love.
The beds and the pillows smell so good.
I know. It's really been nice, though, last weekend and this weekend, just being able to be. And we were going to try to do a live video this weekend, you
we
guys.
We were. We really were.
But the Wi-Fi here
Our
is...
cell service sucks.
It's not good.
We have both Verizon and AT&T, and both of them are 1 to 2 bar,
yeah.
if that lucky.
And we even connected to the Wi-Fi here at the RV park, and it's still, it just wouldn't have been good enough to do
no.
a live.
No.
And
no.
We'll do another live
yeah.
soon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll next weekend we have off, we'll do a live.
Yeah. Absolutely. So, all right. Well, let's go ahead and end this here. Thank you guys as always for watching and subscribing.
Until our next video.
Peace, love, and expediting.
Bye.
What you guys doing?
Bye.
You've liked it here at the RV park, haven't you? Have you had fun? Oh, yeah. They're tired. They just went out for their last hoorah.